Welcome to Gray on Math. We are asked to solve for this problem a circle and a quarter circle and a semicircle are mutually tangent to each other and all are inscribed in a square with side 2 and we are to find the area of the red circle. Okay, so first thing that we have to do is we need to focus on the quarter circle and the semicircle. Since they are mutually tangent to each other, the semicircle and the quarter circle, we can draw a line here. From here into here to the center of the semicircle. And that the two lines are collinear. Okay, so if this is 2, the radius is 2, then this is also 2. This is the radius of the quarter circle. And this is also 2. This is the side of the square and the radius of the quarter circle. And let us call this unknown side to be the radius of the R sub A. R sub A, so R sub A. So this would also be R sub A because that is the radius also of the semicircle. And if that is R sub A, then we should call this 2 minus R sub A. Okay, so it is a right triangle because it is in a square. So we can say that C squared is equal to a squared plus b squared. We use the Pythagorean theorem. The hypotenuse will be 2 plus r sub a squared equal to one side. Let us make one side as 2 squared and the other side as 2 minus r sub a squared. So we have 4 plus 4 r sub a plus r sub a squared equal to 4 plus 4 minus 4 r sub a plus r sub a squared. So if we simplify this, this 4 can cancel out and this r square r a square cancels out. Then we have here, we could add here 4 r sub a and 4 r sub a here, 4 r sub a, and we have as of this we have 8 r a equal to 4 and r sub a is equal to 4 over 8. R sub a is equal to 1/2 units. Okay, so next thing that we have to do is we need to focus on the quarter circle and the circle. So if we set this circle to have a radius r sub b, and if we draw a line from the center of the circle to the point of tangency, it is also r sub b. And if we draw a line from the center of the quarter circle to the point of tangency between the circle and the quarter circle, that is 2, since it is the radius of the circle. If we draw a line from the center of the circle to the edge of the square, we again form a right triangle. And we call this line as x. And this whole length is r b plus 2. So here is a much nicer looking diagram, but we can again use the Pythagorean theorem. So a squared is equal to a squared plus b squared. And for the hypotenuse, we have 2 plus r sub b square equal to x squared plus 2 minus r sub b squared. So we have here 4 plus 4 r sub b plus r sub b squared equal to x squared plus 4 minus 4 r sub b plus r sub b squared. We cancel here the r sub b squared on both sides and cancel the 4, cancels out. If we add here positive 4 r sub b, and for this one we add also 4 r sub b, we now have this cancels out, then it becomes 8 r sub b is equal to x squared. Let us see this equation. Let us focus on the circle and the semicircle. If we let the radius of the circle to be r sub b, this is, and we connect the center of the semicircle to the center of the circle, we can do that as a straight line because they are mutually tangent. This would be r sub b, and this is actually 1/2 we got earlier. So this side of the triangle is actually equal to 2 minus x, because earlier from this center of the circle we labeled this line to be x and the total is 2. So this would be 2 minus x. And since we know that the radius of the semicircle is 1/2 in total, and this distance is r sub b, then this would be 1/2 minus r sub b. And this is a right triangle. Again, we use the Pythagorean theorem. We have c squared is equal to a squared plus b squared. So let's make the hypotenuse as 1/2 plus r sub b squared is equal to 1/2 minus r sub b squared plus 2 minus x. So we have 1/4 plus 2 times 1/2 times r sub b plus r sub b squared equal to 1/4 minus 2 times 1/2 times r sub b plus r sub b squared plus 4 minus 4x plus x squared. This 1/4 cancels out, and this r b squared cancels out, but this 2 also. So we have 2 r b. If we transpose the r b on the left side, it becomes 2 r b on the left. We have 4 minus 4 x plus x squared. So next thing we have to do is we need to manipulate the equation we got earlier, which is 2 r sub b is equal to 4 minus 4 x plus x squared. We need to multiply this by 4. So it will be related to the first equation we got, which is 8 r b is equal to 8 squared. X squared. So if we multiply this by 4, we have 4 times 2 is equal to 8 r sub b is equal to 16 minus 16x plus 4x squared. So but 8 r b is equal to actually x squared is equal to 16 minus 16x plus 4x squared. So rearranging this, we have subtract x squared and something of x squared here. So we have 3x squared minus 16x plus 16 equal to 0. Okay, so there is a coefficient on the second degree term, so we need to multiply it to the third degree term to factor it out. So we have x squared minus 16x plus 48 equal to 0. So if we can solve this by factoring, for the factors we have x minus 12 times x minus 4 equals 0, and also the sum is negative 16, and it multiplies to 12 times 4, positive 48. So, but we need to divide by 3. Okay, so x minus 4 times 3x minus 4 is equal to 0. So x minus 4 equal to 0, and 3x minus 4 is equal to 0. So we have x equals 4, and x is equal to 4 over 3. X over 4, x is equal to 4, is invalid, because if we use x as 4 and we find the distance 2 minus x, 2 minus 4 is negative 2. So it would be invalid. And we find the distance 2 minus x, 2 minus 4 is negative 2. So it would be invalid, because 2 minus x will be negative and there is no negative distance. So we need to use x is equal to 4 thirds. Okay, so next step that we have to do is we have to find RB from what we got earlier with the value of x. We know that RB is equal to x squared, but 8RB is equal to, but x is 4 thirds. So we square that, 8RB is equal to 16 over 9. So RB is equal to 16 over 9 times 1 over 8. So 16 over 8 is 2. So R sub B is equal to 2 over 9 units. So final step is we find the area of the small circle. We know already that RB is equal to 2 over 9 units. So area is equal to pi RB squared. So area is equal to pi times 2 over 9 squared. This would be equal to area is equal to 4 over 81 pi square units. And that is our answer. Thank you for watching until the end of the video. Please like the video if you like our solution. And please don't forget to subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon so you will be updated for more math videos like this. Thank you. Bye.